Robert, Mark Walker wrote in Politically Correct Parables this interpretation of how Jesus' parable might appear if he told it today. In that urban center, there was a woman who was maritally unencumbered. Her job had been terminated without notice, leaving her involuntarily leisured. She immediately suspected that ageism was the cause of her termination, even though the company claimed they were only restructuring the workforce and therefore had to downsize. When her case came before the insensitive judge, she looked uninterested and dismissed it with a wave of his hand. "I find no grounds for discrimination here," the judge barked. But the woman was persistence gifted. She re-argued her case before the judge, claiming that she was terminated because she was chronologically advantaged. The judge again dismissed the case as a nuisance case. After this, the woman became even more persistent. She pitched a tent outside the courthouse and called it Injustice City. The newspaper sent reporters to cover her story, just like they would now, right? She became a local celebrity, appearing on talk shows and giving magazine interviews. The judge said to himself, "Despite the fact that I am respect impoverished toward the higher power and insensitive to persons' needs, if I don't rule in this woman's favor, my reputation is going to be tarnished." So when the woman presented her case again, he granted her real and punitive damages in the amount of several thousand denarii. That's what it would sound like, maybe, in today's words. We're using some of our verbs for today. It kind of makes you glad that Jesus wasn't weighted down with all of the political correctness, doesn't it? His story is simple. The point is evident. Be persistent in faith. The context of this parable is important to the message as well. This story only appears in Luke. And Luke puts it right after Jesus' teaching about the end times. Jesus has just told his disciples the signs of the times, and now he tells them that they must be persistent in their faith. The point is evident. No matter the circumstances or the situation, we must be persistent in faith. Have you ever had one of those times when everything seemed to be going wrong? It didn't matter what you did or where you went or what was supposed to be happening because it all kind of fell apart. What did you do during those times? Who was the person that encouraged you? Did you have someone come alongside of you and say, "Hang in there, it'll be okay"? Or just hang in there? After all, it can't get much worse. Hopefully, I've heard that. Hang in there. You know, I think that's part of what our gospel story is telling us today, is to hang in there. Be persistent. Hang in there. You know, we all go through those times in our lives when everything seems to be going badly or wrong or not the way we want it to go. But hang in there. Never give up. Be persistent. Ray Curley on Eculef told the following: "Pilot the tower, pilot the tower. I'm 300 miles from land and 600 feet over water and running out of fuel. Please instruct." Tower to pilot, repeat after me. Our Father, there are times when it seems that all we have is our faith, and Jesus closes his parable with a question. Through asking how many would be found with faith when he returned, Jesus was telling his disciples and us to keep our faith. Keep your faith. Thomas Edison's laboratory was virtually destroyed by fire in December of 1914. Although the damage exceeded $2 million, the building was only insured for $238,000. There's a big discrepancy in between those numbers, right? Between $2 million and $238,000? Because the building was made of concrete and it was thought to be fireproof. Much of Edison's life's work went up in spectacular flames that December night. At the height of the fire, Edison's 24-year-old son Charles frantically searched for his father among the smoke and debris, and he finally found him. He was calmly watching the scene, his face glowing in the reflection. His white hair was blowing in the wind. "My heart aches for him," said Charles. He was 67, no longer a young man, and everything was going up in flames. When he saw me, he shouted, "Charles, where's your mother?" When I told him I didn't know, he said, "Find her. Bring her here. She will never see anything like this as long as she lives." The next morning, Edison looked at the ruins and said, "There is great value in disaster. All of our mistakes are burned up. Thank God we can start anew." 3 weeks after this fire, Edison managed to deliver the first phonograph. 3 weeks. There are many, many more stories that I could tell you this morning, but I think that you get the point. When Jesus comes for you and me, will he be able to say, "This is my child who never gave up"? He or she kept their faith. May it be so. May we make it so each day of our lives. The key is to spend time before God, seeking his will on a daily basis. You know, it's not just part of our children's sermons, you know, about reading the Bible and praying. It's for all of us. It's for all of us. What do we do? How do we keep our faith? What do we have? You know, I was talking to some of our care team this week, and they have gone and visited, a couple of members have gone and visited some of the ones that are in the care centers, and some of them in the memory care. They said, "You know, we thought that we would close our time together by saying the Lord's Prayer." And they knew every word to it. Do we? What other scriptures do we know by heart that when everything else fails us, including sometimes our mind, that we will still remember? What are those words to the songs that we will remember at those points in time? Do we remember Jesus loves me? Or some of the others? How do we keep the faith? Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, there might be some in our midst who are going through those times in our lives when nothing seems to be going right. And to them, we say, "Hang in there. Never give up." To all of us, you say, "Be persistent in your faith and keep your faith." May we find ways to do so on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, O Lord, that we can continue being in a right relationship with you and a closer relationship with you each and every day. In your name, we pray.